is done. She had a small appetite today. Thank you, honey. That was Logos Kitty. And I'm Jonathan with your case. Welcome to new subscriber appreciation afternoon. It's Saturday. Out of the way. wish to welcome all new subscribers and new visitors, and welcome back any people who already come here on a regular basis, our ASMR friends, and also people just passing through who may never pass through again. Nevertheless, as a matter of appreciation and your spending time with us, I wanted to share these roses with you, and so these are for you. Subscribers, visitors, and in many cases, very much so, real friends. These are for you. They're pale, almost white, but with just a blush of pink. I think they're beautiful. Several birthdays that have built up and or are on their way. Some are a little too far away to be included in this episode, but we'll get to them in due course. And also let me say thank you so much for all your kindness and continued kindness as I try to negotiate seems a little subdued and dark here today, but it's very much a lovely tart, and we've got four or five birthdays. First, let me start with our dear friend, ASMR Colors. ASMR Colors has a lovely channel of her own, and the content is very thought-provoking. She puts a lot of time and effort into her episodes, and she very bravely recently disclosed the experience of going through the challenge of being diagnosed with a mental health condition. And if you're interested in such things, she does a lot of whispering, and I think she does a painting with pencils, and she's just a wonderful person. So it's your birthday. I think you're 30. Yay! Oh, to be 30 again. I wish I was 30. Eliza Sky, it's your birthday. It's either coming up or just came up. Hey, Eliza. Luke Cox, you asked for a birthday shout out, and I think we're fairly close to your birthday. So you're going to get some birthday candle secret happiness. Philip 98. Philip, I think your birthday is a few days off, but I didn't want you to miss out. So consider it. let's do a few regular shout outs, which are anything but regular. Sky Vanillas, hi, welcome. Rose XXX, good to see you. Tiki Tingles, I hope you're back. Hot Sauce 188, welcome. Our good friend Dark Incision, I hope you're still around. As well, our dear, dear friend Maria Tinkerbell, hope all is well with you. Liquid Thunder 2121, hi there. Our buddy Jake Scott graduated from high school. Congratulations, you're on your way. Graduation from high school, wow. Oh man, I vaguely remember what that's like. Kyle Flash, hey Kyle, how you doing, buddy? Our new friend, Kaylee Ballinger.
Primary emotional involvement.
is myself. It's that good. I think the adjective fragrant really applies here. It's spicy, but so much more. If you could take the mouthfeel of what you would call savory and elevate it to the olfactory senses, I would say it's fragrant. It's so good. I'm so happy. Mm-hmm. is certainly okay, but it is by no means necessary between the cashews and the cauliflower. I think it's hearty enough, and you have the roasted potatoes as well. All in all, though, I'm quite happy. Started so well and ended otherwise. This being a true story, I'm going to probably leave out some identifying details. She was full of light and joy. And and a lot of Midwestern charm that that I certainly enjoyed when I lived in the Midwest. Very down-to-earth people. I will say, at the early age of 19, Betty already had a three-year-old daughter, had already been married and divorced. And then one night she met me at a club. That night, and this was back in the day when people, I guess, indulged in such things. On the first night that we met, it was a snowstorm that weekend, and she invited me down to her place, about half an hour away from where the club was. At the time, I didn't know she had a daughter, so I went down, and we had a wonderful first night together, as wonderful as such things can be. Spent the rest of the weekend with her, and by that morning I discovered that lo and behold, she had a daughter who had been staying with her father up until then. In addition to being divorced, I guess Betty had a boyfriend before she met me, who was, I was soon to learn more about. But on that evening, or on the next day, it being Indiana, and it being the 80s, we set out in a snowstorm looking for a liquor store, because we were out of beer and out of bourbon. So we bundled up little Misty and left her with her grandmother, and then we walked at least a mile in the snow, in a snowstorm, I guess you'd call it a blizzard, praying that there was a liquor store open, and uncertainty walking through a snowstorm with a girl who I had just met the night before in search of booze. And we got home and we brought Misty back, and it was at that point later that evening that I saw something showed me, or removed the makeup that was on her face from the night before, and I didn't know how this worked back then. I still don't really know how it works, but she removed the makeup, and she showed me she had this big bruise on her face, and it freaked me out, and she, with much shame, beaten her up. And discover that she had spent the night with me, that he would probably do the same to her. And it was at that point that I told her to go move in with her mother and inform the authorities. But she was so filled with shame, and I just remember how important it was for her. A snowstorm and
There's love.